to Stelzer from the corner. Yes! A three. Back to Stelzer. He'll launch another one. And it's gone! Over to Stelzer. He will. A three. It's gone! To Stelzer. Catches. Shoots. Hits a three-point. Second, Stelzer catches, shoots a three. It's good. Now here's Stelzer. Stelzer drops back, shoots a three. It's good.
Overall, the first year in Spain, first year as a professional athlete there, it went pretty well. It was definitely different in terms of culture, in terms of basketball, which led to some ups and downs. But overall, it was a good first year experience and thankful for the opportunity to do that this past year. Differences between being a college athlete and professional athlete is, well, the most obvious one, you don't have to take any classes. I tried to keep my brain going a little bit in studying Spanish 4 or 5 days a week, whether it's the application on my phone. Definitely nice not having to take a lot of the classes, maybe that you aren't as interested in about. Strictly basketball is nice, especially when that's your passion. So dealing with hours of classes each day was definitely nice. In terms of the expectations on the strictly athletic basketball side, I mean, your title is professional athlete, so you're expected to act like one all the time, whether it be on the court or what you're putting in your body each day, or when you're out in the public and in the community. The expectation is, as the title is, represent yourself and your club the best you can, like you should in college, but would say a little higher stakes with the professional title. It was definitely a challenge at first. The first month was definitely the toughest, just getting used to the culture, and I had a little bit of a Spanish background, but not fluent in any regards. So just the difference in culture, and our head coach for the club that I played for spoke zero English. So constantly having a translator, either from our assistant coaches or the other players on our team, it took a while to get used to and just to catch on to. So that was definitely the biggest challenge. Yeah, other examples that you probably don't think of, I didn't, going over there. Just small examples like going to the grocery store, trying to find exactly what you want with all the names in Spanish instead of English, and trying to figure out that's translation. And just the phone service as well. I had to order data and go in there my first time and figure out, not wanting to get ripped off, the best plan that I needed. And I'd say a third little example is just the food, trying to order food. This past week, I actually decided that I'm not going to return to Spain for the second year of my contract due to a newer injury that I suffered at the end of the year and an older knee injury popping up again and giving me some trouble. My plan is to not go over to Spain, and I'm working right now on coming back to Tech, actually, which was a very tough decision, deciding to end my playing career, but very excited now to return to Michigan Tech, I'm hoping. Working out some details still, but place, community that I love, and excited for the next phase now.